To the right, we have, well, it's written there, Misión Alta. This is part of the Anglican mission when the first religious people arrived here to Ushuaia in order to evangelize the natives. And remember, the Yamana people, they used to live here. We have, well, those highest mountain near Ushuaia. Behind those mountains, we have the winter resort, situated 20 kilometers away from here, 30 minutes. Those people that they capture, they catch the king crab from here, from the Beagle Channel. We have these hear sailing boat because some people they go to the fjords and they go to the Cape Horn.
The prisoners would clamber down from the train to start their day, still shackled together. There was an inner circle of guards made up of the unarmed jailers who gave the orders. Beyond them was a second ring of guards armed with rifles. Both sides of the track, the so-called tocones, which are the tree stumps that remain, cut at different heights and with irregular marks. This is because, firstly, a variety of tools were used. Single handheld axes and two-handled saws worked by a man at each end. Secondly, the logging work carried on every day, summer and winter, no matter how bad the weather, and the prisoners used to saw the trees at ground level. If you look at the stumps, you can picture the height of the snow at the time and work out at what time of year the trees were felled. The shortest stumps were trees felled in summer, and the tallest were those cut down in winter. The first, called the end of the line, transported about 20 prisoners who had the job of laying the tracks on top of sleepers made from lenga, a tree that is commonly found in the area. Cut to size on the job, extending out the new sections over which they would travel. On days when it snowed, the prisoners who traveled in this first train also had the job of clearing away the snow that had collected on the tracks using picks and shovels. Everything from being kept shackled to having their wages docked were having their break times reduced. There was a time when the punishment was even more extreme, such as leaving the prisoner standing for hours outside, exposed to the elements with soaking wet clothes, or keeping him confined to his cell for long periods of time with only bread and water. Macabre races were organized in the cell blocks, in which a prisoner was made to run while the guards beat him until he passed out. All these abuses contributed to the decision to close the prison. In 1947,
started out Mr. Herschel.
mentioning every single Gen 2 penguin that we see. There's lots more on the port side now. And if you're on one of the higher decks, you can look down into the water column and see them swimming underwater. And you'll appreciate how majestic. Up in the center, whilst the other ones will produce a curtain of bubbles to confuse and disorientate the krill, and then one in the center will come up and take a gulp of the food. And I think we're witnessing that right now.
Yeah, right there.
It's a big circle. Look at that.
Thank you. Thank you.